or a movie star, and you go, yeah, I just don't. Sometimes I don't. Sometimes I don't feel like you walk like a movie star. And I go, what are you talking about?
Well, I have.
You just came out tonight. That was perfect. That's how a movie star walks out.
See, I know how to walk. I have. It's like a different persona, you know, that comes on when I'm on stage. Like I know how to walk in heels, and you know, I know how to do that. But in my day-to-day life, me and my dad walk the same.
Okay.
Which is not necessarily a great thing.
No.
We call it the Coltman trudge, and it's kind of. I mean, I can't really do it in heels because it's not as ugly. But my day-to-day walk is more of like this.
That's your day-to-day walk.
This is my day-to-day walk.
Yeah, and how's it on the red carpet?
And then this is my red carpet walk.
Ah!
I'm gonna go with three.
All right, yep.
Lucky number. Okay.
Three, lucky number. Here we go. We can do this.
Okay, okay, okay.
Okay. Oh, you can put it in that little thing.
Okay.
Yeah, here we go. Mm-hmm. It's a song.
Okay.
Yes. Three, four, five words. Oh, boy. First word, the. No, I will always love you. I see. No, look. I see through you. I glare. I stare. I stab. I slaughter. I rip. I rip chainsaw. I saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus.
That is good. That is good. That is how you do it right there.
All right. We can do this, pal. We got this.
Okay.
All right. That took them way too long. All right. Give me a number, guys. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
This is great. No, we're all fine with you starting.
This is fantastic. This is just, I'm so excited about this. Thank you so much for coming over. Okay, you ready for this?
Ready. Okay, it's a movie. Okay, two words. First word. Baby. Second word. Baby Driver.
What number? Seven?
Seven? Seven.
That's a good one.
Okay.
Oh no, why my partner does. Put me a little thought into this one. Yeah, Billy, you seem ready to go.
I'm gonna do this.
You ready?
Okay.
All right, here we go. Okay.
Song.
Song, yep.
Uh-huh. Two words.
Two words.
First word.
First word.
Shark.
Shark attack. Shark bite. Chomp. I bite. Eat you.
Dragon.
Attack.
Crocodile. Crocodile tears. Crocodile.
Croc. Crocodile rock.
Big. Oh!
Yeah, we got it. I thought we could do three fun boomerangs.
Let's do it.
Is that good?
I'm down.
All right, I have this.
Okay.
And then.
So am I going first?
Yes, you go first.
Thing of confetti. All right,
let's
do
maybe
this.
Yeah.
Like a lot or like.
Yeah, maybe do a lot and then blow it into the camera.
Okay, okay.
And that'll be a good boomerang. But you have to say 3-2 or 1-2-3.
Okay.
Which one are you gonna say?
3-2-1 or 1-2-3?
I don't know. We have to make
a
decision.
3 is my favorite number. 3-2-1.
All right, so we go 3-2-1.
Okay.
3-3. Yep.
3-2-1.
I screwed it up, I think.
Yeah, that's great. No, that's great. There's absolutely no piece of confetti was in that.
I screwed it up. I didn't know what to do it.
All of that.
I didn't know what to do it, man. Okay. What am I supposed to do? All right, you show me how to do it. Right,
so
I'm gonna do one now.
Okay.
I'll do a spit take, okay?
Okay.
Oh, there we go. Three, two, one. I'll take a sip and then I'll look that way. And go,
okay.
I'll do a spit
cool.
take. Okay?
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Is that good? Am I framed up?
I'm the millennial. I got it.
Three, two, one.
I mean, come on.
Wait a second. This is the best one I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah!
You know how to do it.
How did you do it? You just press it once?
Yeah.
Just press it once. Man, you were fantastic. I'm saving that one.
Yeah, that's a good absolutely.
One. All right, I think we do one more. Okay. I got a good idea for this one. This one, I need to
spit on my vote.
We'll go over there. Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Thanks.
Oh, no, I didn't spit on your vote. I didn't. Here, you can come over here. This is Captain Kirk. Kirk, you hold that. Do you know how to do it?
Oh, yeah, pretty much.
All right, so 3, 2, 1, you just press it. That's it.
Yeah.
Just press it one. You don't hold it. That's what I was doing.
No, no, you don't hold it.
I was holding it.
It does
I think
that.
You stand there.
Okay.
You put your hand out like that.
Okay.
And then I'll get behind you. Kirk, is there
Line
any way that
she,
I can bounce? She can bounce me?
Yeah.
You got
down,
it?
Down, up, down, up.
Like that?
Up, yeah, down, up, down, up. Yeah. 3, 2.
Did you do it?
Yeah.
Yeah, we got it?
Let's see it.
Hey!
Hey! What was the training like? I mean,
okay, so our director called me and he said, you know, listen.
He was great, by the way.
So amazing.
And I don't know this director.
So talented, Michael Gracie.
Yeah.
So amazing. He's going to be huge.
Yeah, he was great.
But he called and he said, listen, you know, we want to workshop this like a real Broadway production. I'm like, cool, that's great. Then he's like, also, you might want to start working out because you have trapeze rehearsals when you get here and I want to use the stunt double as little as possible. So I was like, okay, so as soon as I got there, it started, you know, building upper body strength, which I don't have and have not maintained either. So don't ask me to do any trapeze when you see me because I don't have it anymore.
That was a different time.
It was a different time. But it was a lot of training, a lot of just literally getting up there and just going for it. I remember I had been rehearsing on this specific rig that I was used to. You know, I'd become normal with that height difference. And there was a net and I felt good and comfortable and I had been doing it for a while and I was like, okay, cool. Like, I'm a trapeze artist. Like, this is great. And I show up on set and, the rig was like 15 to 20 feet taller. And there was no net.
What?
No net.
Oh, no.
Because back in the day, they didn't have those yet. So I was hooked up, so I'm safe, but
still,
visually, that's a lot to get over, you know?
Oh, yeah. I would say, hey, guys, it's called CGI. Look it up, and let's figure out this. Get this net right now, and we'll zap it out later, man.
Yeah.
Airbrush it out, man. I don't care what you got to do. Shoot around it. I need two nets, in fact, yeah.
Right. That was my thought process. And then it's right as I was going to go up, right, in the cherry picker to go up to the thing. And Hugh Jackman walked by, and he goes, Zendaya, you're a badass. And I was like, take me up.
Take me up. I can do it. I can do anything. I can do anything.
Hugh
Jackman told me I'm a badass. That's all I need to hear, man. You and Zac Efron, we were saying earlier, great chemistry. You guys look like you're a great team. Like, you could actually go take this on the road. You can actually be in the circus.
But no, it was great. You know, Zac was such a great partner. We really had to, like, one of our first kind of getting to know each other sessions was like, okay, here you go, you know, you're harnessed together, get up there and there. And so we really had to quite literally trust each other because he had to hold my weight and I had to hold him, you know. So it was just kind of like a great icebreaker. Great icebreaker.
That's the way, guys, if you guys want a good first date, just join a circus and just figure out getting the trapeze together, see if it all works out. Yeah. But you were saying those takes where you guys, because it's just, it's gravity. So, I mean, things.
So there's this specific, like, thing we do where basically we're holding our own weight. So there's no harnesses in this one, unfortunately. We're holding these two ropes and we are together and we swing apart from each other. They lift us off the ground. And, of course, that momentum of us swinging as far as we can go away from each other, we come back together and, you know, we're supposed to grab onto each other with the other arm and begin like this swing, which is in all the posters and it's beautiful and that's great. But if you don't catch each other.
Yeah. We actually have a little iPhone video clip of you guys working on the scene. Here is Zendaya and Zac Efron. Watch this. Nope! Let's do one more take, yeah. How many of those happened? That's not as romantic.
Yeah, and that's just one of the many that we could choose from.
Yeah.
For that specific body slam.
This is a big deal, because you have your first feature film.
Yeah.
But everyone knows you from the Disney Channel. Yeah. So this is like a big you breakout role mm-hmm. for you here. Who do you play in Spider-Man?
I play a character named Michelle. Nobody believes me though that's my character's name, but it really is Michelle. It was so much fun. Like I said, this is something I've been wanting to do for like a really, really long time. You know, I wanted to get into movies, and this is finally it. And it's crazy that it's Spider-Man. Like. Yeah. That's my first
and
thing.
And did you know it was Spider-Man when you were auditioning? Because they keep everything
no,
very quiet.
No, I did not.
They
I knew
that
I was
yeah.
auditioning for Girl in Movie.
Girl in Movie. That makes you feel good,
then,
yeah.
Yeah, no, it was great to get into character. It really helped. in fact,
Let
I didn't
me
even,
become the girl. Okay, I'm a girl.
I'm the girl. And I didn't actually even know what kind of character, because my character is very interesting. She's, you know, like kind of like a loner. She's super intellectual, very like dry humor, one-liners, pops in, pops out. And I didn't even know what kind of character I was gonna play till like I got there and got to sign a non-disclosure and then read the script.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, and then you get the script.
And then you get the script. And then
you're
I found
really
out.
Funny.
And I was like, wow.
You got some great one-liners in this movie.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, it's
Thank
great.
You.
But you were saying that you're psyched to see other parts of the movie because you weren't in. The parts that you weren't in were all done.
Yeah.
And you're like, hey, that's what that looked like?
Exactly, because I was in, you know, I'm in like the Peter Parker side of Spider-Man's life, right? So everything that I shot when we were shooting, it just felt like I was shooting like this like awkward teen coming of age comedy kind of thing. And then you realize like, wow, when the trailer started coming out, like this is a Spider-Man movie. Like this is like action. Like it's going down, you know?
Oh yeah. But this one, if I might be wrong, but this one is basically Peter Parker and Spider-Man he's ready to up it. And he's not your friendly neighborhood Spider-Man anymore. He wants to get into the Avengers.
Yeah.
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 Oh, yeah.
It's a big deal. I mean, it's the Marvel Cinematic Universe, people.
This is it. It's the Marvel Universe, man. Get ready.